feints that Forrest is using. Very effective. And that's been one of the subtleties in this fight that has worked in the favor of Forrest. The other one is how well he's cut off the ring when Pete Rillo tries to give him a sleight of hand move there by Forrest, and then he finishes it off with blazing speed. I'm going to tell you, this is as good as Forrest can look.
Oh, heavy right hand over the top by Forrest, just as you said that, to punctuate. Rock and a right hand, and down goes Pete Rillo again, and Arthur Rickety stops the fight.
That's it.
Left, the bone of vein is connected on Ali's right jaw. This is not picture fighting such as Ali is used to. Not easy against Bonavina. Look at that. It's like an alley brawl as far as Oscar's concerned.
You're right, Steve. He's a tired fighter right now.
As we approach 30 seconds left in round 10, Bell smacking Mormec all over the place. There goes Mormec's mouthpiece. And Mormec's in trouble. Bell smothering him. He goes down for the first time in his career. Crumbles to the canvas. I don't think he's going to make it. Wayne Kelly waves it out. It's over.
Not wasting any energy, dancing, he's just brawling.
Just really overwhelmed him with speed.
And you're looking at a guy who was once one of the best boxers in the world. Now he's showing his slugging.
Doing a great job covering a lot of angles. Looking like the Camacho of old.
Look out, Hobbs in trouble. He goes down. And this fight is over. Sam Berouet waves it off. With 48 seconds left.
Usually not a factor in the lower weight classes, though. They're always in good shape. Back out trying to unload now. Marty Dinkins stepping in, taking a look at what's going on. Sanchez taking a little punishment, and then he goes in and he holds.